The mobile marketing ecosystem is constantly evolving and moving rapidly towards a privacy-centric future. One of these changes is the new guidelines introduced by Apple that require developers to use SK Ad Network to measure and optimize user acquisition campaigns. These changes have caused a lot of concern and confusion in the industry. So we wanted to take a look at one of the more complex aspects of SK Ad Network, namely conversion values. In this short video, we will explain what conversions are, how an app developer defines them, and how best to optimize them. So what are conversion values? Conversion values are how SK Ad Network enables app developers to grade the quality of users they acquire to better measure and optimize campaigns. A conversion value represents an action done by a user in an app. For example, a purchase, or the completion of a level in the game. This value is then attributed to the source of the install to enable campaign measurement. The value is configured by the developer. It represents a characteristic that the developer believes is a reliable indicator of the value of that user. What does that look like in practice? In SK Ad Network, conversion values are formatted in binary logic using 6 bits, or 64 signals. You can think of bits like a switch. The switch can either be turned off, meaning the binary digit is 0, or turned on, in which case the binary digit is 1. Apple provides developers 6 bits in total. By turning on or off the 6 bits, there are 64 different combinations available, the lowest value being 0 and the highest 63. You, as the developer, will get to decide how you use the bits and set what each combination means for you in terms of what you want to measure. We know this isn't easy to understand, so let's take a look at how you can make conversion values work for you. Let's keep it simple to start. Here are some basic strategies. First, you can go flat. With this method, all 6 bits measure one KPI. In this example, the app developer is using all 6 bits to measure revenue. If the bits were turned on or off, as illustrated here, 110001, due to user activity, the conversion value that would be returned by SK Ad Network is 49, meaning $49 in generated revenue. Next up, you can split them two ways. 3 bits for measuring revenue, for example, and 3 bits for measuring game progression. Here, the user spent $5 and completed 6 levels. Finally, you can use the combo split. This combines the split method we just saw plus a deterministic on-off signal. Here, the last bit we saw is used to verify whether the user has completed registration or not. Once you have the basic strategies down, there are some more advanced options too. First, you can use the flat splitting method for predictive analytics, for example. Alternatively, an advanced split method might use 2 bits relating to cohort data and the remaining 4 bits to measure revenue. Finally, an advanced combo split method might use 2 bits for measuring 3 days of cohort data, 1 deterministic signal, another signal for a value prediction, and then 2 final bits to measure revenue. Your end result might look something like this. Don't worry if it seems complicated. These more advanced strategies may take a bit more time to understand and get exactly right. So let's summarize the key points. First, you need to define how you want to use the 6 bits available to you. Then, you'll want to make friends with the binary logic by mapping all of your conversion values. And finally, but most importantly, start analyzing campaigns, extracting insights, and optimizing your conversion values and user acquisition strategy. If you want to learn more about getting the most out of SK Ad Network conversion values, visit us at appsflyer.com.